Simple truth is that the 97% don't agree with our 3%. Yeah. They are not in the same level at all. Yeah. They're looking for war. They're looking for conflict. They're looking for all kinds of negative things, yeah, that come back in our life again and again. Right? Now, I don't want to go too much into it, but there is one point to make it also easier to understand, and that is the speed, how the subconscious works in us. Yeah. So let's say consciously you make a step of 30 centimeters. This is more or less what we call 1 foot, right? This means 1 step. No. That would be the length we can do consciously. And our subconscious would do at the same time 22 kilometers. Yeah. So the speed, how our subconsciousness works, is so, so much higher. Yeah. Right? And this is the reason why we actually cannot win in this relationship. No? So the subconsciousness, because we cannot see it, yeah, it appears in us, or it appears to us in the other, in the outer world. Yeah. There we can see it, and this is the reason why we manifest what we manifest collectively. We manifest our subconsciousness. That is what it is. Yeah. So there is this demonic side of us coming out and comes in the world, and every one of us says, no, I have nothing to do with that. That is the only the result of some special people. They are in power, they are evil forces, there is a group of people, they rule the whole world, they are only 10 people, and they are the devils, and we have nothing to do with them, right? Is it or not? Yeah. But it is not like that. Yeah. Because they could never do that. This could never manifest if all of us, or such a many people, billions of people, carry a total different program in their heart. It would never be possible that this manifests. Yeah. Never ever. Right? And this is what the quantum physics teaches us. We're all connected. Yeah. That means, for example, if there is one enlightened person, if you come in the field of one enlightened person, you feel it immediately, you know, and it transmits to you, and you feel completely different. Yeah. And if it is just a good person, you feel it. Yeah, doesn't have to be an enlightened one, just a good person. Yeah. My mother, for example, was a really good person. Yeah. My mother-in-law, for example, is a really good person. Yeah. And you can feel it. If you come in their presence, you feel there is something in order. They bring a healthy thing to you. No? Yes? And if we were all in that level, there would be a beautiful world around us. Yeah. So what we have to do is not only not to produce weapons, because this is what we want to produce. That is just thing. What will happen? That prevents a third world war or whatever there is, you know, maybe it will not be possible by now anymore. Yeah. But let's say in long term, yeah, it is always the same thing. There is only one way. And this is us, looking at our subconscious, whatever you will find there. Yeah. That is, the work, yeah, There's no other. This is why it says in Sufism, who knows himself knows God. Imagine. He knows not knows the other. Yeah. He says, you know God. You know the divine. If you know yourself, you know the divine. Is it interesting, right? Yeah. But before you come to know the divine, you know all these terrible things which you have to face inside. Yeah. Jealousy, envy, pride, all these things, you know, that we don't want to look at. We say, this is not me. I have nothing to do with that. Right? But because we don't want to see it, so we go into relationships and the other one, yeah, shows it to us. And that makes you to understand why our love relationships are so warlike. No? Is it or not? And you see the most terrible of yourself, you see it when you live with somebody. Yeah. This is when you find yourself really terrible. Yeah. Before you can have all kinds of ideas. But the moment you find yourself in a couple, yeah, you learn to see how you look like. And of course, you say again, this is not me, this is the other. I was good before. Yes, I was super. Yeah, I was very good before. Now the other, he makes me to be like that. Nobody can make you to be anything what is not there. Yeah. You cannot become a monster just because somebody is there. Be and express what is living inside of you. Yeah. But of course it lives subconscious. That is the whole point. And this is why it's so terrible, shocking. When you understand, oh, whoa, 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 there lives this part in me as well, and you don't want to contact it. Yeah. Usually we don't want to contact it. So in a couple, you contact that, you know? Okay. And the whole world is in contact with us. So this is what manifests. Yeah. This is what we are. This is what people see when they come as a cosmic tourist. Then they see, wow, they are really here on the killing. No? It's a killer planet. Yeah, we are killing all kinds of beings, is it or not? Yeah. So, and this is the work. So when you think you make a spiritual work, that is the work. Yeah. There is no other. And this is the only revolution which can happen. After we evolute, yeah, because that is, we have to evolute, no, to come out of this point, yes, yeah. So I want to describe a little bit how our emotions, especially our emotions, which are these containers of energy, work with each other. Yeah. How every one of us is in a secret network, not so secret really, but maybe not so conscious to you. Yeah. And you can study it, especially in a family. That is very interesting if you have children, but you can study it also as a couple. So think it. Well, you can think it with your hand, with the fingers, for example. No, maybe you heard this sentence: "Everyone lives in his bubble," or "Everyone is an island." Have you heard that sentence? Yeah. Let's say it is like this. Yeah, we can agree somehow on that. No, we are not really in the same. Yeah. So you live in your bubble, I live in my bubble, but there is a connection. Yeah, and we can call it, for the sake of easiness, there is a connection like a pipe. Yeah, think it like a pipe where there would run water through it. Yeah, okay. If you like, you can think it also like an oil pipe. So now, when you have an emotion, yeah, anger, that's a very male a very male emotion, for example. Yeah, it is. If we had to divide our emotions, we could say that women suppress anger and aggression, and men, what do they suppress? What do the men mainly suppress? Yeah, fear and insecurity. Yeah, right. So when you are angry, yeah, but you don't express it, yeah, you hold it down, yeah, you hold it down, you hold it down, you hold it down, yeah, and you are not aware of it. Not aware of it, that you hold it down. Yeah, it's just living in you on the other side, that you are not wanting to connect. No, you know it somehow. There is this killer can come any time up. Yeah, but you don't want to connect with that, right? It's not attractive. So you hold it down, 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 down. Then there comes pressure in the pipeline. Yeah, and booms, in your wife it appears. Yeah. And you think that you are a cool person, yeah, that you are totally peaceful, and then you say, look at the wife, you say, what is that? Yeah. Yeah. And she freaks out. No? And when you do that over a long time, you know, you have permanently a wife next to you that freaks out. Finally, she goes to the psychiatrist, yeah, or to the therapist and psychoanalyst. And she says to the psychoanalyst, you know, I don't know what's happening to me. You know, I'm freaking out all the time. Yeah, lately. Yeah. Why do you think that can be? And the therapist looks at her and says, what do you think? You know, because the therapist also holds his emotions down. Yeah. You know, I don't know how many psychiatrists you met in your life. I met a lot. Yeah. Not because I went in one mental house after the other. But my life brought it like this, that I'm almost surrounded by psychologists, therapists, psychiatrists, people who work in general with people. Yeah, they appear a lot. And especially with the psychiatrists, I have never seen one that could not be his own patient. Yeah. Of course, imagine you work with people that are completely out of the box, yes? And you have to develop a kind of shield, a kind of system that holds you stable, yeah? You can't really open, yeah? You can't really let them in a way. So you become very, very controlled on a certain point. And somewhere it has to appear, right? And you will not believe how many psychiatrists are on drugs, you know, on all kinds of crazy medications. Yeah. So this kind of pressures is very important to understand. Thank you.
Thank you.